Hi everybody, here is Jens from Tabletop Generals, and today I will build some fencing over here. I have here some jumbo craft sticks. These are 8 inches long, so 20 centimeters, and they have they are waved on the outside, so no straight edges. And this is the base for the fence. Then we have here some matchsticks to build the fence. And yeah, what else do we need? Some wood glue, which is watered down, so that it's a creamy, milky, sort of. And then some tissue paper. Yeah, so let's start building some fences. So first of all, I've done some research on the snake rail fencing and found an article for a do-it-yourself building of these fences. And he said, or he wrote down in the article in his blog, that only one part of the wood is touching the ground. And there he placed some stones, and that's more or less the common way to do it. So I looked up the pictures and did some test runs, and that's what I came along with. Could be very similar to them, to the fencing Travis did, the Tabletop CP, but I'm not sure. A long time ago he showed some fencing, but I'm not sure if it's the same way or another way. It's too long ago. But Travis, hey, if you watch this one, and it's more or less similar to yours, thanks, even if I can't remember that you did it the same way. Yeah, so first layer done. And as you can see, there's only a small part touching the base. And yeah, now I do 6 more. And in the meantime, this one will dry. So it dries enough that I can build up the next layer. Oh, I need some more matchsticks. These matchsticks are 4 centimeters long. I think that's, what is it, 3/4 of an inch in addition. Or, no, 2/3 of a quarter. So no real numbers for your imperial measurement. But yeah, it's 4 centimeters, so I think you will get along with it. You can, of course, take longer or shorter ones. You just have to figure out how to place it with the angle, so that it looks nice and easy. It's a very easy process. Just putting a drop of the PVA on the point where you want to place the rails, and then put it there. And here we go. Next one. Yeah, let's talk about some future projects here on the channel. World War II is still going on for roughly 4 years, and then I will not stop doing World War II, but I will shift the focus towards other conflicts and theaters of war. And as you might guess it from the fencing I'm building over here, it will be somewhere in North America, and it will be in the black powder era. So I'm planning to do some French and Indian wars, some American War of Independence, and maybe some American Civil War. I'm not sure about the schedule, so when I do what, but I will visit all these theaters, because I really, really enjoy that part of the history. Even it's not a European history, but it has a great influence on the world and how the world is today. So that on itself made the conflict interesting. So, and as you watch me building these fences, I can talk a little bit more. This is the second time I tried to do this video. The first time it was a rant and ramble, and I can't stop talking nonsense and stuff, and I was not happy with it. So this is the second time I do the video. Here now are 7 of these pieces during the English version, and 7 of them during the German version. So it's 14, and in the last try I did also 7, so I have 28, and then I tried to do them, so I have now roughly 40 of these pieces. So 40 makes it 8 meters of fencing. That should be some fences. but you need a lot. I have seen this on several tables when you try to build large fields and do them along the roads. Even if the board is only 6 foot long, you need 12 foot if you do it on both sides of the road. And if you have a T-junction on it, then guess what? There are 8 foot more. And now you have 20 foot of fencing you need, just to do fencing all along the street or the road. So I think you see the problem. So I will do a lot of these fences so that I have enough. If you can ever have enough fencing. I think they also work well for fantasy stuff. And yeah, they did it in North America, so maybe they did it somewhere in the rest of the world. I'm not sure, but I will find out, and then maybe for other times and other regions, I already have some fencing. As you can see, it works quite easily and fast. I'm not in a big hurry, and it's not that complicated. And the first layer for these seven fences is nearly done. Yeah, it has not to be perfect, just do one or two test pieces, or 10 test pieces, however do you like it, and then just start mass producing these fences. Boom, here we go. As you can see, it's the first layout done. Let's get back to the first fence. So now in reality, so the real fence will start and end somewhere. These bases are shorter than the real fence would be. So somewhere here the fence ends, but maybe not on the gaming table. So I have to decide how I want to create the end. But it should look like it could go further. Well, there are two possible ways I found out for me. And one way is to just put next layer on it, just so, and lay it on the other part. That's one way to do it. And the other way is to take a shorter one and put it on the side of it. I hope you can see it, so that it reinforces the fence a bit. And then let's start. And then when you put the first matchstick on, and you just can give it another go. And as you can see, it's very easy. Hope you can see something of the work, and not most of the time my fingers. And I have no issues with some broken matchsticks. I can use them for poles or broken parts of the fence. I also will do some shorter ones, so to just have more variety. Oh, that's how it looks after the second layer. Now let's do one more. I could do a little bit while longer, the entire video, so you can watch me just talking nonsense. Or I will show you what I have built, or what's more or less the end of the building process for the fence. not sure what I should talk about for that long time, until I get all 7 fences to that level. So I think I just will show you the second one and then just give you a finished one. It's not finished yet, but the build is done. Well, you can see how it looks. Oh, here's the next one. Yeah, and how does it look when I'm done with it? So it's the fence. Finished building. I will do some basing, of course, and then just brown and dry brushing. You can add some poles if you wish on several points, but that's what I like, and yeah, quite an easy. So for the height, here is a kneeling Rogers Rangers dude, and as you can see, yeah, he can fire over the fence, and the fence is a little bit higher than 2 centimeters. So we have what's this? 3/4 of an inch or stuff like that, so 2 centimeters. It's okay. I can easily add one or one layer or just 1 or 2 pieces, but I'm happy with the height. Yeah, that's it. So if you like what you see on my channel, it would be great if you check out our Patreon page. It's not that I am not able to continue with the project. It's just, it makes a lot of stuff easier if you have some extra money from time to time, to get some projects going or continue them. So it will be very appreciated if you take the time and take a look at our Patreon page. Yeah, so hope you enjoyed this one. Like, share, subscribe if you haven't. And yeah, have a good one. See you in the next video. Bye.